And yes, there is going to be a power play option, which is one of the new things. Other enhancements, of course, is a time clock. And yeah, how does that affect everybody?
Well, it's new to these players, and it's a definite distraction. If your strategy discussion goes too long, now you rush down and you throw, and now you're completely thrown out of your routine. So I think the key is going to be to manage that time and those clocks.
Can you hear the music? Well, there's going to be more music while they're playing, and that's not the only distraction. Everyone plays and throws basically the same time.
I don't think the music's too big a distraction, unless it's you and I singing with it, but it's when the music stops, it's the real problem.
You get, there's your thinking time, 20 seconds. You cannot throw, obviously. When it goes green, then you have 20 seconds to throw.
Now here's the very distracting part. Thomas has to wait for the music to stop. Sometimes you want to go, sometimes you don't. It depends on how you're wired. Wayne Madal would have thrown four rocks by the time the music stopped. So it really depends on how you like to play the game.
I might be able to get to pretty close to nose.
We gotta go. Whatever weight you want, you just gotta hit as thick as you can.
Yeah, you gotta hustle here. Mentioned Hugh Milligan, he's Vancouver born. In fact, he was in that very first event I ever did back in 1986, representing Ontario at the Canadian Mixed. Gotta get going. There you go. Wow. You see, that's the problem.
No pre-shot.
And there'll be a lot more discussion later in the game, too. So that's where they're going. They can't bank any time. That's the part that's scary.
Yep.
The last thing you want to do as an athlete is be rushing and not happy with what you're trying.
Oh, boy. Just made it to that tee line.
We're really going to cut down the scoring area, though.
We don't need to move it far.
Just, okay. Sure.
It's
filling.
It's good that Eve actually kind of overcrowed on that. It kind of peeks out the other side and is available for them to use.
It'd be almost nice if we could freeze that other one, but
this one.
So the clocks on the floor have gone away, so the players will have to adjust. They'll know through the music. So now they're into that throwing mode of the 20 seconds.
I'll take edge, I think.
Yeah, I like it.
Bit wide.
Okay. Wait there right
okay.
now.
Roll for line.
Back four.
Roll line, Kaitlyn. Get on the other side if you can. Hard.
Trying to get it to move.
Back eight.
Keep going on your shooter. Whoa.
Okay. Kick that into a great position and roll behind the tee line so Team World cannot come off it.
Shoot.
As long as it's a try mark.
What's happening? Just fixing the clocks?
Good scrum.
So the umpires are just informing the players that there is a timing problem. It's all software. And there you can see Hugh Milligan trying to make that adjustment. They have to reset it. So they'll probably just go with the music until they get the clocks reset.
Yeah,
would be my thought.
Okay.
This morning we had one game ended a tie, so they split that point. No extra ends. Right now, Team World is leading on sheet A.
Even if I just cold
Team North America
on
leads
third.
On sheet.
Yeah, I like
it. Almost
B
eliminates the back one.
And North America leads on
if I bump
sheet
it a little, it's
C.
Okay.
Yeah.
Really?
Well, he's got to hustle.
Yeah. Okay.
He's got to hustle.
Apparently we're supposed to wait.
What's that? I'm confused. Oh, that was their rock. Is this one gone then?
Is it broken?
I won't sweep it then.
Oh, okay.
A little confusion there.
Sorry, I'm confused.
Yeah, Mark thought he was racing to throw.
So the umpire is coming in again.
Rethrow.
So there was a timing issue.
Rethrow again.
Now they're just going to try and figure out what happened. It just touched that stone.
Mark thought he had a lot of time, got the hack looked over with work.
Yeah, it surprised me too, actually.
Yeah, it was quick.
It's really slippery there. It's really fast.
Faster.
We did.
So Marc Kennedy gets a rethrow here because of the the time clock, as you could hear the official.
Just fouled up the shots all across the board.
Yeah.
This is the gong show right there.
So he's going to just let it go. And I think, again, what happened earlier in the game, we'll just play a conventional doubles game. Now he's being told just to wait.
I got you.
Am I throwing with them now, though? I'm on world clock. Okay.
So I was hack.
Yeah. Andy Kapp for Team World. 13 German titles, couple of silver, 3 bronze in the World Championships. 4 Olympic Games. Andy. Now the signal to rethrow for.
With the one clock running, Vic, they had to wait and slot themselves into the very next shot because the other two teams kept going. Yep.
Right.
Now they're back right at it.
Hard, Kaitlyn.
Help!
Hey, get out of the way. Sorry.
Well, I mean, you don't hip check your teammate.
Oh, boy.
Oh, sorry.
And they get
good sweeping.
Come up as light.
You know, the funny thing, they were better with the first one.
I was actually thinking it was a great opportunity. You got 2 throws at one, but
the mulligan you didn't want.
No.
It was different with the music and the timing, and it just wasn't consistent. So it was just a new challenge for us.
Yeah, it does. But you know what? They're trying to find something that works and that's exciting and interesting, and it is. It's fast, and you got to. Right now, I just roll with the punches, and hopefully they can get some of those little things figured out. But all in all, it's so much fun to play that, no complaints.
Oh, this is interesting. Now, this is, you heard the music. So Alina Pätz is elected to throw during her thinking time.
I think it's just so hard. Some of these players, they sit and wait.
Too early? Oh, I'm sorry.
Wow. Too early. Oh, so she was penalized for going too early.
It's not great.
It's tough for these players. They're so used to getting in the hack and throwing when they're ready.
So the stone comes away.
So
it's, as we say, it's a work in progress. It's an experimentation. Brings now Jones back and having to be pretty quick here as she's now down to the 15, 12 seconds to throw.
10.
This is what you said about the time clocks, Cheryl, and about how they can affect the throw.
They can, like your pre-shot routine, it might have to change. You might need a different pre-race shot routine for mixed doubles because it just doesn't allow you the time.
I might shove that megaphone into. Oh, it's a walk.
Fuck yeah.
And the team, North American team of Natalie Nicholson, Tyler George, U.S. champions, have picked up one. They're still down as they play in the third. Rachel Holman, John Morris picked up the deuce in the first.
When you let it go,
Yoshimura and Erickson, 8-1 as they play in the fifth.
Well, even if she smokes this, it's still missing our three.
Holman got the deuce, got 4 in the third, and they stole 2 more in 4. Remember what Jeff Stoughton said to us, that Holman and Morris had played together, and it's showing here their experience.
Well, yeah, if you just hand-picked a team, that's one you'd pick.
And John's talked about how much he loves
from
mixed doubles.
From who's to not throw, right?
From the fitness aspect. And
1 second, we're here. We've got looks like we've got a bit of a timing problem here. And it's down at the other end.
That's the problem with this whole system.
So there we go.
Before any movement.
How much is 2 feet? Like about half a second before we hit the rock. Or just touch
it. Put it back again?
Didn't move it.
So it's on sheet B where the problem has arisen. Okay.
leave it?
All right.
Okay. Thanks, guys.
This is the experimentation. The problem is, if one, they want all the sheets to play together, understandably. But when one sheet bogs down, one sheet has a problem, then all the sheets are affected.
It does, and that takes you again out of your routine in a different way. Now you're waiting for another sheet. They were ready to throw.
Well, the gentleman on the left, Hugh Milliken. Now, while we're away, Team North America on Sheet C, that's Rachel Holman, John Morris, have picked up a steal of one to lead 9-1. Now, we are in a timeout. The reason being is that the Team World and Oscar Erickson had made a good shot. Yet, as we saw earlier, the shot was probably made late and not within the shooting time frame, that period where you have to deliver the stone. That nice rock that Erickson threw would be like a hogline violation. And it was pulled. And now the discussion is, and John Morris is saying, you know what, the guy threw a great stone, leave it be. Well, if you're playing by the rules of mixed doubles, then that stone has to come off. And that's why there is a one on the board. Yet John Morris is upset, and so is Team World, and their coaches and captains are also going down to the head official. So at the moment, all the games are in a technical timeout. You see Paul Trulson. There's Andy Kapp, the captain. Rick Laing, coach of the North American side, and Swiss Helm, all there, talking with the head official and trying to figure out why was that stone taken off. It would only be seen as a violation of the time clocks, in my estimation.
That's the tough part here, is John being such a wonderful guy. Oscar makes his brilliant shot. The crowd goes crazy. All of a sudden they pull it off. John doesn't want to see that happen. He feels there'll be a reaction with the crowd when the score goes up backwards. It's a 5-point swing.
Yeah, it's not good for the game, and John knows that.
They should get 4 points for it.
And Alina just got pulled out too because she was.
Yeah, it happened on another.
Safe guard.
Can we say cats?
Safe guard.
Cheaters.
And in fact, that's what you've heard, I think it was Ann Swisshelm say. It happened on another sheet. The rock was pulled because they threw. Well, in fact, it was. Was it our sheet where the rock was pulled because she threw out of this?
It was.
Yes. It was Pätz that threw within the thinking time. You can't. You have to throw within your 20-second throwing time, and that's why it was pulled.
You saw John walk up to Oscar and say, hey, I tried. He doesn't want this.
I give John Morris a ton of credit here. Unfortunately, the rule's the rule, but John saying, hey, you made a great shot. In the spirit of the sport, there's no better than John Morris, and he really wanted the opponent to score that four-ender. Pretty cool.
But again, remember now, it's the thinking time. You can't throw in that red. When it goes to green, that is your throwing time. Then, of course, the amber or the yellow is your running time.
The difficulty with this too is the other sheets have stopped, and the fans, you know, they're just waiting.
So as we mentioned, this is a work in progress, and this is something that the World Curling Federation has to resolve, and has to resolve quickly. They wanted to enhance, and they hope to enhance the game for its debut doubles at the Olympics, and all that's good, but you can't get and let the crowd get away from you, because they're not aware of what is taking place. This is not what they want to see. They want to watch curling. So whatever they decide to do, improvements, music, clocks, this is what they cannot have happen.
Well, then.
So the discussion continues. with Paul Trulson. We'll take a quick break and hopefully they'll resolve this and we'll get back to curling mixed doubles on a Friday afternoon at the Continental Cup. Well, the discussion continues as you see Oscar Erickson is now over talking with his teammate, Christoffer Sundgren, as well as Alina Pätz. And now he's calling Oscar over. Now this, I don't disagree, but the rule is the rule. And if John has in mind to throw a few points their way, I don't agree with this either. And so we'll see what happens here as we resume play. So we want to keep you updated on what's happening on that sheet C, that game featuring Homan Morris against Yoshimura Eriksson. Again, the problem was that Morris believes that Eriksson's stone should not have been penalized. So the first two stones thrown by Homan Morris, they've just put them through. And now Morris settling into the hack, and we'll see what he does with this one.
Whoops. Sorry.
You're good.
He believes that they should have gotten minimum four points for their last rock. And so now the crowd acknowledging that he's pitching it through. Now, I'm not sure. I mean, listen, the rule is the rule. I personally believe this is like taking the goalie out. You fill the net and we'll get back into the game. Jeff Stoughton joins us again. First of all, explain what happened on sheet C to lead to this.
Yeah, what happened was that last stone for Team World, they threw after the time clock had expired. And so all the teams were informed before this game that they were going to enforce that rule this time around. So the umpire's call is that that rock does not count and it gets pulled. I mean, that's the rule. And they were told before this draw that they were going to enforce it. All the players knew that. So really nothing at fault by either team other than what's going on right now in the sheet. I think they should just play it out normally and let it go.
Okay, so maybe noble what Morris is attempting to do here, but the rule is the rule.
Yeah, I mean, rule's rule. We saw it here on sheet A with Alina. She threw during the thinking time,
right,
and they pulled that rock as well. So they all knew it coming into the draw. It was made specific before this draw. They told all the teams they were actually going to call it because they did not call it yesterday, but all the teams were told that it is going to be called, and it's just the way it goes. I mean, everyone's in a learning position, and it's just one of those things.
Okay, so further to this then, and we'll let you go here. Is this something then, when you sit down with Curling Canada and you move forward with the World Curling Federation, will you come through with your own ideas as an association to bring to the table at the world level?
Yeah, and I mean, just so everyone knows, this is not the rule right now that's in place for the Canadian Championships or the World Championships this year. This is just a trial run to see if a clock system would work or be beneficial to the game. So it's just an experiment and seeing how it works. So definitely there's going to be feedback from ourselves, from Curling Canada and the WCF. We'll talk about it and see how it can be adjusted and made better and see what else we can come up with. But just, you know, so everyone's clear, this is not going to be the rule for the Canadian Championships or the Worlds this year. Every other rule that's been changed is, but other than these time clocks.
Okay, Jeff, thanks for helping us out and clarifying things for us.
No problem.
So we'll keep our eye on sheet C as well as we come to the final few stones here in our featured game. 6-5, Jones and Laing leading.
That's what I was trying to tell you. I think that was your line.
Not to belabor the point, but if the teams are made aware of the rule, John Morris, as I say, noble intentions or not, if it was a hogged rock, they're not changing that rule. They've been told the rules and you have to abide by it. If you want to fight it after to get the rule changed, that's fine.
And the good news is it looks like there'll be a rule change, as Jeff mentioned, and John would like to see. It's, the power play makes some sense, the music makes some sense, and it's, I think it's, you need a duration for the entire game as opposed to each shot.
Mine is good. Yep. Whoa.
was that any good.
Great draw by Alina.
Yeah,
this is the same come around you threw last two ends ago in the power play.
A little bit deep. She wanted it just above the tee line.
It's a good, good one.
Chance for Jen to freeze.
Yeah, top four, they would have the angle slash, wouldn't they? But at least it's in there. Forces Jen to a good one.
So, back on sheet C, where this all began, you can see that they are currently sitting 1, 2, 3, 4.
12.
Final stone for the team of Homan and Morris.
All right, John.
You got light, Jen? What do you got?
Me too, light.
And there you go.
How's the line?
Line's good.
And Morris has basically said to Oscar Erickson.
Needs to curl here.
And Sayaka Yoshimura, you were deserving of four. We're going to give you your four back. And they're about to get their chance.
Jen had great weight on hers. It just didn't finish.
All right.
Pretty much wide open.
Okay, it wasn't a foot higher. Be a double for four. Just deep enough.
Brent was on that as hard as he could.
Back 12.
Yep. Etch a four shouldn't be that.
It's fascinating how many high scores are with so little rocks.
Sayaka Yoshimura, final stone.
It's good too.
Draw the 8 foot for four.
Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy.
That's a curl at all.
Jesus Christ.
So four on yellow, or four on sheet C. Four yellow. One for Pätz and Sundgren. We're all even. And hopefully everyone's happy. Is the Rat Pack still around? Picking up an extra point.
Yeah.
And the 1 point. Make the final 9-7.
Almost.
So they've taken two of three. Meanwhile, on sheet C, where we had all the controversy, Homan and Morris will get 1 point back with a win over Yoshimura and Erickson. And so Team North America, after doubles play, leads by one, 8-7. Interesting afternoon, to say the very least, here in Las Vegas and the Continental Cup.
Yeah, I think there's some really good things that have been done. You know, the fact that we got music in the background, the fact that, you know, the power play, those are great things that have added a bit of you know, energy and some spice to the game of mixed doubles. The timing thing is really has been a lot to adjust to and a little bit confusing for us. And I think that, you know, it's something they're probably going to look at and reassess maybe at the end of the year. You know, maybe go back to normal thinking time. It makes it easier on officials and players and you know, everyone above. But you know, it wasn't an error on the officials. They were doing their job, and you know, we were. It just feels really bad. It's like you know, it's like when a rock picks and they had a, you know, hit for four or something. Like, it just feels really bad to take a win like that. So I felt that you know, that they deserve the 4 points on the scoreboard, and we lobbied hard to make sure we got that. But at the end of the day, we didn't. So we wanted to sort of, you know, make it right.